Greetings to you all, wherever you may be. My name is Sara Warber. I am a holistic family physician and a researcher into the healing effects of nature. In my current project, I am lifting up creative voices, especially those of women. I am speaking to you today from the Great Lakes region of the United States, in the land of the indigenous Anishinaabe peoples on the shores of Lake Michigan. I acknowledge and honor Kiwaidinokwe, Anishinaabe storyteller and healer, who profoundly influenced my views and taught me that health is dependent on the interconnectedness of the balanced individual, mind, body, heart, and spirit in harmony with the family, community, environment, and a greater spirit around them. As you know, we have a problem expressed by this circulating meme. How is it possible that the most intellectual creature to ever walk the planet Earth is destroying its only home? Perhaps it is our unbalanced intellect that is leading us astray, with its emphasis on increasing consumption and technological solutions. What if we look to the heart, to creativity, to show us the links between health and nature, to inform our views of how to live a healthy life in harmony with nature? Close your eyes for just a moment. Imagine yourself completely healthy. What are you doing? Where are you? When I asked my patients to make drawings like this, I was surprised to find out that almost every one of them drew themselves in nature. A man with Parkinson's imagines himself serenely meditating in the dunes by the lake. An obese woman with seasonal affective disorder imagined herself slim and swimming easily in the shining sun. I urged my patients to put their picture where they could focus on it daily, knowing that this conscious imagineering would guide their micro decisions throughout each day and surely lead them to their health goals. Imagine, what does art do for us? The ancient Greeks taught that art is imitation of nature, that art could capture beauty and elicit awe, or even the transcendent moments such as we experience in the grandeur of nature. Hester Berry's art is rooted in this traditional representation, but she challenges herself to explore ways paint can distill the effects of light, time, movement, and climate, capturing the feeling of the moment. Jean Stevens takes a closer look at the details that make one stone or plant or animal, in this case birds, distinct. She hopes that her work inspires others to learn about the wonders in their backyards and the diverse web of life. Imagine ecological grief. We can become undone by sadness and despair when we feel nature's current plights so deeply. Psychologists are just beginning to recognize this reality for their patients. Instead of labeling this as abnormal, though, they are learning to identify that this is a normal response to a grossly abnormal situation. These two pieces of art, often displayed side by side, have become a signature of ecological grief. On your left is Albert Bierstadt's 1870s rendering of a pristine Western American waterfall, while on the right, in Valerie Hegarty's early 21st century work, destruction is rampant. Brazilian street artist Eduardo Cobra pairs two iconic images of environmental catastrophe, a polar bear on a melting iceberg, surrounded by water so polluted that it catches fire. His work both triggers and bears witness to our collective ecological grief. Imagine art as activism. To raise awareness of plastic in our oceans, underwater creatress Christine Wren, shown here with 30 days of her own plastic trash, challenges her viewers to try purchasing no plastic for 30 days. Could you do it? Christine and Margaret Wertheim began the Crochet Reef as a testimony to the disappearing wonders of the marine world. Taken up by others around the globe, the Crochet Reef is a unique fusion of art, science, mathematics, and feminine handicraft that may well be the largest community art project in the world. Imagine new inspirations for living, such as dreams and visions, new narratives of our relationship with nature and our more than human kin. Inka Essenhai connects us to the world of the collective unconscious, the mysterious space of dreams and archetypes. Her mythologies strive for the feeling of an inner vision, yet are grounded in nature's otherworldly twilight hours. In Pat Allen's series entitled Things Fall Apart, we see the wild wolf challenge the flimsy monetary check as the artist longs for her beloved mountains and struggles to find her voice for wilderness. Imagine interconnectivity, reciprocal healing. I heal the earth heals me. Jessica Perlstein's visionary painting of the new eco-city is inspired by ecological interconnection and influenced by regenerative culture. Architects and designers are already beginning to make her vision a reality. Looking deeper within that vibrant growth, we find a host of creatures and interconnected processes of wild culture, as celebrated by writer Laura Johnson. Here, Beric Henderson, artist and former research scientist, shares his vision of the evolved human completely engaged in symbiotic reciprocity with life and nature. Imagine a new map. Like my patients, we need images to hold our focus and our dreams of personal and planetary health, so that we can make the emergent decisions that will bring us to the mutual reawakening that sustains life. Métis artist Christy Belport, in Offerings to Save the World, embodies love for the earth and the awe of it all. She writes, "Everything, the plants, insects, winds, stars, rocks, animals, us, is a giant web of pure spirit. The great mystery surrounds us every minute of every day. The sacred laws of this world are of respect and reciprocity. If it is possible that we live in a planet surrounded by stars, then nothing is impossible." Thank you. I look forward now to our interconnectedness.